Are y'all having fun? I'm sorry that you are not having as much fun as we, but thanks for hanging around.
I'm drunk.
Yay!
Again?
It was a long break.
You can't take him anywhere. Is everybody here? And he's going to be here. Guys, welcome Mark Douglas Brown and Mark Gorman back.
I thought what you wanted was someone to point you with the wind. I thought what you needed was someone to stand you up again. I thought what you wanted was my winded advice. But now I know you didn't need to hear it twice. And I guess that I was caught up in my own dreams. I wasn't listening to any of yours, it seems. But before you go, I hope you know you have my vow. Darling, I am listening now. See, I tried to be the judge. I tried to put you on the stand. I thought that I was softening the hard places that you'd land. And I talked to you till you were blue in your pretty face. And I talked all over you and backed you up into a tiny space. And I guess that I was caught up in my own dreams. I wasn't listening to any of yours, it seems. But before you go, I hope you know you have my vow. Darling, I'm listening now. Come on, Mark. There is a dance between two people, takes a lifetime to learn. Gets more complicated with every little turn. Well, you were trying to tell me that your feelings, they were real. I was trying to tell you how you should really feel. I guess that I was caught up in my own dreams. I wasn't listening to any of yours, it seems. But before you go, I hope you know you have my vow. Darling, I'm a listening now. I'm a listening now. Welcome back. Thank you, guys.
Well, that was good. That was a good one.
Yep. Yeah, I told that to my wife. I know what you told me.
Confession time.
You know, she's sitting right next to you. She can hear you. Oh, is that your wife? Okay. Fair enough. I'm glad we worked that out. I'm glad you're here.
You know? My mother.
Where's Judge Karen when you need her? All right, so I know this can be shocking to some of you fine folks. I am not a natural Spanish speaking fella. That's not even the funny part. Wait. So,
struck my bone funny.
All right.
Good.
So,
see.
So I wanted to say the big picture in Spanish. And so I was going to my natural Spanish-speaking friends, and I was asking them, so would it be El Foto Grande or would it be La Foto Grande? And I was getting mixed messages. And I was like, how is it that you speak the language but you don't know how to speak it correctly, you know? And I went home that night and turned on the news, and there was some white fellow speaking English. He didn't know how to speak that correctly neither. And so I go, oh, I got it. But the explanation that made the best sense to me was that the word is actually fotografía, which would make it feminine. And just because you shorten it to slang doesn't change the gender of the word. Now, I don't know if that's true or not, but that seemed right. So I recorded it that away, and I'll be singing it that away tonight. So it'll be La Foto Grande. It's on the record that away, okay? So it's
okay? No entiendo. I don't know. I don't understand.
Ladies and gentlemen, La Foto Grande. World passing by through the window of a big Ford dinosaur on wheels. Ain't life from the back seat as the miles roll by. If I'd only known back then that was a good day. La Foto Grande. Everything I own is in my car. The old folks looked on and my mama cried. Ain't a life from the front seat never seemed this hard. If I'd have only known back then that was a good day. Yes, sir. La Foto Grande. Well, our dreams are out of reach and we're standing in a mist. Can't see the light, but we're hoping for the best. Take a look behind us and we take another breath. The grand plan that brought us all here, well, it's perfect, yes. Baby, take a look around. So take a look around. Room seems quiet in here tonight. Gathered all around just to say goodbye. And our life seems strangely sweet near the great divide. If I'd only known back then, wouldn't have it any other way. Gonna touch the face of God today. Foto Grande, baby, take a look around. Foto Grande, we better take a look around. Foto Grande, say to take a look around. Foto Grande, ooh, take a look around. Thank you.
I like that a lot.
Thank you.
You with me? You still in the band? What's going on? The band just broke up.
Where? Is that
what is that?
No.
All right. Everybody, yeah. Just remain calm. Just be cool for this next one. I wrote this song with a great friend of mine from the Northeast. Her name is Abby Gardner. She plays the dobro. It's the sliding sort of instrument. She's a wonderful songwriter. lovely human. We sang it as a duet on this record of mine, but she's not here, so the role of Abby Gardner will be played tonight by me. Thank you. I've made mistakes, I've made them all. If I couldn't run from trouble, then I would crawl. When it came to mistakes, man, I've made them all. I had love in my life, but I let it slip away, leading me to wonder at the end of the day why I built it up just to watch it fall. I had love in my life after all. And when it came to choices, I often chose wrong. But even those bad choices, they move me along. Now I cannot regret what I've learned from my mistakes. I have let words fly from an angry mouth. I've held back forgiveness, I've given in to doubt, and I slipped in to silence when I needed to shout. I've slipped and fallen so many times. I got bruises all over this heart of mine, but it led me here straight to you, as if I knew, as if I knew. When it came to choices, I often chose wrong. But even those bad choices, those things moved me along. And then I cannot regret what I've learned from my mistakes. Been there, broken down, cracked wide open where the love is found. And the beating of our hearts fell right in time, tapping out a rhythm only the broken can find. So if this is the path that led me to you, I will bless each misturn and every sky that wasn't blue, and I will pray that I've learned from my mistakes. Yes, I will pray that I've learned from my mistakes. You got to get this kind of action going in your life. It's more fun than you can shake a stick at. This is great. Get a friend like Mark, who plays really good guitar. That's my advice to you.
It'll look like E, but it'll sound like D.
I see. Not. Yeah, that's trickery. What sort of sorcery?
Sorcery, yeah.
Yeah, wizard.
Yeah. Oh, golly. This guitar is hard to steal. Yeah, it is. Well, Miss Kelly tried to. Oh. Okay, so.
Paparazzi.
Turn the show. He didn't break it.
Miss Kelly tried to. But I have. No, but Miss Kelly has tried to surprise me a number of times with guitars, and the UPS fella kept messing it up, and he sure messed it up with this one because he arrived when I was coming home and handed me this box. And Miss Kelly was not a happy camper. She said, "Supposed to be a surprise." I said, "I'm surprised."
How many guitars are you giving out? Like,
well, she's on a pretty good roll. She's a pretty good roll.
We're friends.
Oh, we're more than friends. Sound right?
That's a lot of. You okay? Yeah. Let's take a rest. Why so blue?
I like a cold beer.
Yeah.
Woo. On a hot afternoon. I like a cold, cold beer on a hot afternoon. And I like a cold, cold beer on a hot afternoon. And I love you, baby, all night long. I can say, baby, I'm from Texas, 'cause I've lived here all my life. I like cowboy boots, I like a big belt hat, and I like my jeans to fit just right. I like pickup trucks, I like this good guitar. I like girls that are long and lean. I like Texas skies, reach as far as from El Paso clear to Palestine. You may find me in a canyon when the sun is sinking low, or a Texas highway bound for nowhere with no particular place to go. I like the coyotes cry at sunset, like a mourning dove at dawn, like a cold, cold beer on a hot afternoon. Love you, baby, all night long. Here we go. New Mexico may be enchanted, while Oklahoma, it's just okay. When that Missouri girl, she said, "Mark, show me something cool, man." Texas blew her state away. You may find me in Amarillo, Abilene, or Livingston, in Austin, Texas, down on 6th Street, San Marcos, or Galveston. I like the coyotes cry at sunset, like a morning dove at dawn, like a cold, cold beer on a hot afternoon. Love you, baby, all night long. I like a coyote cry at sunset, woo, 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 like a morning dove at dawn, like a cold, cold beer on a hot afternoon. I love you, baby, all night long. I like a cold chowder box on a hot afternoon. Love you, baby, all night long. All night long.
So cool, you have all those Texas songs, you know, Texas, right? There's no like songs about Connecticut, right? You know, like, you know, where I live, there's none of those songs, you know? There's no Sweet Home Alabama for Rhode Island, you know?
from Rhode Island either, I bet you.
It's a very small place. Anyway.
You feeling lonely, Mark?
No.
No.
Not
I feel
all.
I'm in the right place.
Oh,
I know you're not lonely.
Well, I can only. I'm going to play you this song. It's a song of place. It's from a geographical situation. Mm. I'm really high right now. I was thrown out of Northeastern University in Boston, and I ended up at the University of Florida, where I had a Hertz rent-a-car map on the wall in this awful apartment in Massachusetts in Boston of the state of Florida. It seemed great. You can go down there and sit on a stool and, you know, play songs, play some Cat Stevens songs and get paid. And I did. It's been one long day since then. And I went back to the city of Boston, and it was, you know, you're a young guy. Things get weird when you're that age. I wrote down my memories. It's a made-up song. It's called Boston. Looking back, I thought I knew it all, 19 years old. Dropped off in the city feeling wild and bold. Wandering the Fenway with no money, no plan, but man, life had begun. I was supposed to switch trains at Park Place, I did not care. Every night I was riding the red line up to Harvard Square. With a guitar and a heart full of what I thought was poetic despair. Man, I was up for it all. But here I am all these years on. Of course, I'm wondering where that time has gone. Boston, you're looking at a very different man. Searching for who I was back then, and I'ma walk in your streets again. Come on. Got psychedelic cartoon children in the afternoons. Got them up there on the rooftops, they were baying at the moon. It was all so full of meaning then, so maybe it was true. Once you get that high, can only feel low. I'm gonna meet the man in a Mission Hill alleyway. Got me walking Commonwealth Avenue all the way to Back Bay. But the twilight made me long for my home again. Even then was the loneliest time of day. Here I am all these years on. Of course I'm wondering where the time is gone. Boston, you're looking at a very different man. And I'm searching for who I was back then, and I'ma walk in your streets again. I recognize who I was in those days, but I'm searching every corner through the fog and haze for that unknown, unwashed soul lost to time and space, gone now without a trace. And here I am all these years on. Of course I'm wondering where the time has gone. Boston, you're looking at a different man, and I'm searching for who I was then, and I'm walking your streets again. Boston.
Well done.
Thanks. I'm glad I remembered the words.
When I first, somebody talked me into doing a CD, and I had a bunch of songs that just that I'd written, and so I made me a CD, and $10,000 later, my living room and garage were full of CDs, and I was looking at them one day thinking, I might ought to get out there and see if I might can sell some of these suckers. And so I did. I started going out and playing a little bit, and I got a break kind of early, earlier than, man, it was too early. It was one of those breaks where, you know, it was so early I wasn't able to capitalize on it like you could maybe later when you had a little momentum. But, you know, I was going to get to go to Poor David's. I was going to open for Gary P. Nunn. Pretty good gig. I didn't even know who Gary P. was. I mean, I know now, but I didn't then. And so all I knew was I was going to be playing for people. And I was used to playing for a bartender looking at his watch, like if he'd put that guitar up, I could go home. And some guy passed out under the stool there. So anyway, we show up, and I'm excited, and we're doing our sound check, and the back door's sloping, and this rowdy bunch of ne'er-do-wells come stumbling in, and it's Gary P.'s band, and they hear we're playing, so they kind of settle down a little bit. And one of the guys says, wow, they're pretty good. He said, what kind of music do they play? And somebody in our group of folks that was with us said, it's kind of like a Texas kind of country. And he said, ooh, Texas kind of country. That'd be a great name for a song. And he said, hey, Gary, did you hear that? And Gary was walking in about the time, and he says, Texas kind of country. I think I'll write me a song called Texas Kind of Country. Well, I hadn't met him yet, so I hop off the stage and walk up to him. I said, so you're going to steal our idea? Heck yeah, I am. I said, I'll race you for it. So he laughed, I laughed. Well, sure enough, we're playing, and there's people, just like this right here. And I happen to look back over here, and Gary P. has snuck in the back door, and he's got his hat pulled down kind of over his eyes. About halfway on the bar stool, he's got his arms crossed across his chest, and he's looking down, listening. I thought, man, that's cool. You know? And so we did okay. We played well, and I was kind of hanging out at the back there. And then they played, and, of course, they were killing it. And during the third set, he called me up on stage and took off his Telecaster and handed it to me, and I got to play with the band for the rest of the night, and that was cool. Nice. So when it was all over, Gary went to all our CDs and T-shirts and whatever we had, and Gary and I were hanging out at the bar back there because that's what musicians do. And he goes, man, he said, you're a great songwriter. He said, wonderful guitar player, great voice. He said, what are you doing next weekend? Now, we're very successful musicians, so I said, nothing. And he said, why don't you come on down to Green Hall and open for us? I said, cool, Green Hall, what's that? Yeah. I know now. And that week I figured it out, baby. And I lit a shuck down there, and I beat everybody. I beat my band, his band. I beat Gary. And I'm down there just soaking it in, and everybody starts kind of coming in, and we start setting up. And then Gary walks in. So I walked up to him and said, hey, did you write your song? And he laughed. He said, no, did you? He said, did you? And I said, heck yeah, I did. Well, we played that night, and I'm telling you, it was wall-to-wall rednecks in that place. It was muggy. You think this is warm? Woo. It was raining that night on the outside and kind of raining on the inside. And there were so many rednecks in that place. If one redneck dancer went to the bathroom, they all danced or went to the bathroom because they were stuck together. When we finished playing, we'd sold all our records and whatnot. I was sitting at one of those little picnic tables over by the windows over there, you know? And Gary P. picked up his acoustic guitar and hopped off the stage. He could still hop off the stage back then. And he walked over to me, handed me his guitar, and he sat down beside me, and I played this song right here for him. It sounded just like this, only without the reverb. I hope. Hey, now there's a place way down in Texas
where all the cowboys bring their cowgirls out to see. A little band to play an infectious kind of music that they like to call a Texas kind of country. Well, I ain't got nothing against the boys from Nashville, 'cause I know they really understand how to pick and grin. But still my heart beats to a little swinging rhythm, a Texas kind of country that puts me in the state I'm in. Well, I know that I just might be biased, but when you're right, you know you can't be wrong. So raise that shiner box, sorry, and get that Lone Star flag sign while we play Texas kind of country all night long. Hey, now I can tell, mister, you ain't from around here. So let me see if I can explain what I mean about that Texas kind of country and why it's so dear to every God-fearing, hell-raising Texan you've ever seen. Well, I know and I just might be biased, but when you're right, you know you can't be wrong. So raise that shiner buck up to that Lone Star flag, son, while we play a Texas kind of country all night long. I'll play a little bit. If you ain't from Texas, then you can't get loud. That was lame. There's a bunch of people from Oklahoma here. Or Rhode Island, maybe. If you ain't from Texas, then you can't get loud. If you can't get loud, you just can't have no fun. Baby, have some fun, but take care of one another, 'cause I'm wanting to go home with the armadillos like Gary P. Nunda. He loves that part. Well, I know that I just might be by you. Well, you're right, you can't be wrong. Raise that shiner box up in salute, son, while we play a Texas kind of country all night long. While the boys play Texas kind of country all night long. While all my friends play a Texas kind of country all night long. Talking.
Bring up Oklahoma.
It's okay.
No. Nope.
Rhode Island. It's so small, the whole state is wall-to-wall carpeted. Rhode Island. Woo! That counts as a song. Wait a minute.
standing on the edge of the turquoise sea, thinking about you, searching for me, untying the lines, casting off the winter's ghosts. I'm letting you blow away. I'm letting you blow away. Wild bird lands on a low wire. The day is done. The sky on fire. I got one hand holding tightly on the mangrove root. The other one is, it's letting you blow away. I'm letting you blow away. The rush of the wings of the low-flying loon. Heavy weather coming on. You got the yellow moon. Carried you with me down every wild road I've run. Now I'm letting you blow away. I'm letting you blow away. Letting you blow away from the deepest places, out across the bay, over the gulf into the distant forming storm. I am letting you blow away. Not that I won't always love you. It's not that I won't always care. But I can no longer hold you in these strengthening winds. So I'm letting you blow away. I am letting you blow away. I'm letting you blow away.
I've said it before in this room. It's very intimate in here, and it's nice when you sing a song with your eyes closed and you open them up at the end of the song and there's still people here. So thank you for that. You know.
Ain't that the truth?
I mean, you never know, you know.
Wow. That's true. I'm going to hang a left on you real quick. I'm going to play a song I wish I'd written. Yeah, how about that?
Ta-da!
Yeah, I think the best thing that's ever come out of Del Rio, Texas is a songwriter by the name of Radney Foster. He's written some great songs. When I grew up, I hoped to be a songwriter like Radney Foster. And I got to open for Radney a number of years ago, and I was so excited to do so. I'm such a fan and stuff. And they say, don't meet your heroes, you know,
still disappoint you. But Radney, he was cool. I mean, he was a little weird. He's a songwriter, so, you know, we meshed pretty good and kind of quiet. He, nice guy. And I knew I'd be playing for a full house that night, and I was excited about that. And I got up and played the show, and I did well, you know. And then I was hanging out at the merch table at the end, you know, listening to Randy's part of the gig. And this big old tall fellow walks up to me, and he says, "Hello, I'm Jack." And I said, "Hi, Jack. I'm Mark." He said, "I know." He said, "Wow." He said, "You're a great songwriter, dude." And I said, "Well, thank you." And he said, "You're a good guitar player and wonderful singer, you know, blah, blah, whatever." I said, "Well, thank you, Jack. I appreciate it." And then the conversation kind of waned, and there were just two grown men staring into each other's eyes, and it kind of got weird. So I said, "Good to meet you, Jack." And I turned and walked away, as one would, right? Mm-hmm. And later on, I noticed everybody's getting their picture taken with Jack, though. So I'm like, "Yeah, that's weird." So anyway, I go home that night. My wife said, "How was it?" I said, "It was great." And I met this guy tonight, though. His name was, like, Jerry or Jimmy Ingram, something like that. She said, "Jack Ingram?" I go, "Oh, yeah, Jack Ingram." She said, "Honey, he's a national act." Oops. I didn't know, you know. I know now. What do you think?
Same thing happened to me and Dean Martin one time. Long story.
A couple of months later, we were walking, we were down the street in Fort Worth. We were going to see La Levitt at the Bass Hall. You know, I happened to look over my shoulder, and there's Jack and Amy walking behind us back there. And I said, "Hey, honey," and there's Jack Ingram. And I thought I heard him say, "Hey, honey, there's that son of a..." They didn't know who I was. This is not a Jack Ingram song. This is a Radney Foster song. I can see her in that water, church dress hung up in a tree, splashing, flirting, laughing, teasing me. Afternoon of secrets, swimming naked in a pool of dreams. Last high school summer, dripping dry, Sycamore Creek. Well, she kissed me one last time, heading home. I'm still haunted by what she said when I'm alone. She said, "Boy, you got a chance to be free of all these small town strings that tie the rest of us down." She said, "Boy, you quit your hanging around. Take that guitar and run faster than the setting sun. You can write a song later about my memory. You can always come back. You can always come back to Sycamore Creek." Well, the guitar made the magic, and I just hung on for the ride. I've walked amongst the giants, played with legends side by side. She came to see me in New Orleans, and on the tour bus after the show, I kissed goodbye the one never should have let go. Chance to be so wild on those guitar strings, stage lights in every town. Hey, look at where you're hanging around. Take that guitar and run faster than the setting sun. Hey, you can write a song later about my memory. You can always come back. You can always come back to Sycamore Creek. Ella knew she'd gotten married. I always forget the guy's name, but he played tight end the year we won district. It got bad and it got ugly. Through tears one night she called me. I drove 10 hours to the water. I couldn't resist it. Said, girl, you got a chance to be free of all these small town strings. Cut the ties that keep you down. I said, girl, you quit your hanging around. Take this money and run faster than the setting sun. Well, she soaked my shirt, crying over memories. I said, don't ever come back. Don't you never come back to Sycamore Creek. That one, baby.
Beautiful song.
Now tell Radney next time I sing. You said so.
He knows who I am. That song put me in mind of this song I made up. It sort of feels like the continuation of that song. And it's...
I've been wondering how that worked out.
We'll tell you how it ends. Neil got out 96, worked the Michigan plants on the straight, married Jenny, lived in the sticks. Just getting by the best they can, keeping a few steps ahead of where they began. At night, Neil goes out and has a smoke, out in the tiny yard under the giant oak. Takes a deep breath, closes his eyes, and he sighs. He says, give me something. Give me something here that I can feel. Give me something real. He says, Jenny, every day when I walk out the door, I lose track of what it is I'm walking out the door for. When I punch the clock, I only want to punch the wall, and I know that punch won't do nothing at all. But inside of us there's a river, a valley beautiful and true, and if you let me in, I'll let you dare. See, at night, I trace my finger on a map from Cape Ann to Bimini, from Santa Cruz to Hampton Bay. I just close my eyes, drop my finger down on any dot along the way, and I say, give me something. Give me something down here that I can feel. Give me something real. Jenny says, maybe something real's what you already know, whether you stay, Neil, or whether you go. Maybe something real's wherever we call home, and if you let me in, I'll make you feel less alone. sure life gets hard. It's not always fair, and there is injustice and bullshit everywhere. But inside of us there's a valley beautiful and true, and if you let me in, I'm gonna make you feel something. Make you feel something beautiful and new. I'm gonna make you feel something true. 'Cause my love, love, love won't let you down. When you're walking with me, you're walking on solid ground, and I'm here to stay. I'm here to stay. Now Neil's eyes were caught up in a stare, looking at Jenny in the late day sun, dancing on her hair. And for a moment, he felt a welling up inside. But he pushed it down, he let it slide. As he turned to walk to the house, looked back, he said, Jenny, when you're standing right in front of me, there's nowhere else in the world I need to be. And he walked away. And Jenny leaned on the giant oak tree, said a silent prayer, took a deep breath, and closed her eyes and sighed.
In quiet contemplation about my rocky high school day. An awkward kid with no direction, sometimes just wishing I could fly away. I met a friend and he made the difference. He spoke of things that I understood, taught me to sing and to play this guitar song. Now I'm going higher than I ever thought I could, singing Rocky Mountain High. I learned to reach for the sky. Rocky Mountain High. Yeah. This old guitar helped me find my identity. His music helped me through the pain of all the adolescents. Cruelty that not being cool back in your high school can bring old, but now with all those years behind me, well, I can smile because I know the home is safe and how you get there. You can take me home down country road, singing Rocky Mountain High. You taught me to reach for the sky. singing Rocky Mountain High. My phone rang one early Monday morning with the news that my friend was gone. Though I never met him, Lord, I knew I'd miss him. I picked up this old guitar, played a little song, and I sang some Rocky Mountain High.
Take your temperature. You guys all right? Everybody good? A couple more? Is that about it? Yeah. For our viewers at home, our play the... Are we on? Are we on now? Is that how it works? Really? I would have dressed up. I would have worn some socks. I thought we fixed it in like post, as they say. No?
I can't put socks on you.
You don't know that. All right, well then.
Knock our socks off.
Then I'll leave you. I'm going to leave you with this song, and then you'll take us home. That's how this is going to. This how it's
okay.
Go. Okay. Randy asked. Mentioned this song to me. I hadn't played it in a while, but I'm gonna do it tonight. It's a song once again from my homeland of Rhode Island. In the summertime there, I live. On an island. I actually live on an island off of Rhode Island in a place called Block Island, and I have this very small bunkhouse. It's like just a tiny little thing behind the National Hotel, which has been there since the turn of the century. We're inside the National Hotel. I have been running a tab since 1997. And I'm never going to pay it, you know? It's real beautiful there. And sometimes writing songs is really easy. You know, I met a guy who was a retiring yacht salesman, and he, we sort of went out on the town for like a couple days, and I wrote down what he said. And before I go, I'd like to say, Helen and Randy, thank you guys for this. What you guys do here is really special. This is amazing. Thank you all very much for letting me be part of this this weird little gathering in a back room in Texas. I feel very welcomed here. For sure. This is called Passing Through. afternoon of the storm, I stood on Sunset Hill, looking through the pouring rain as the great salt pond was filled. Beyond the point, the sea was wild, the gulls were diving down to the churning spray of the Block Island Sound. Michael was from an island family, lived there most his life, and I met him in the hotel lobby. We talked into the night just before the twilight faded. As the storm returned to sea, Michael stopped to collect his thoughts and he said to me, he said, the more that you live and the more that you learn, that the winds are gonna blow, the tide is gonna turn, but you are temporary. Me and you, we are only passing through. Michael had a wife and two children, ran the charters on the bay. After 70 years of making plans, he was living for today. He said, with the storm come the changes, rock is only shifting sand. When I was a boy, the shallow harbor used to be dry land. And the more that you live, the more that you learn, that these winds are gonna blow and the tide is gonna turn. You are temporary. Me and you, we are only passing through. Ceaseless waves upon the shore, the winds are gonna blow, and time will erase your footprints when you go, when you go. And the world will keep turning on and on and on, and the world will keep turning on the sun. When you're gone, when you're gone. Michael said, memories are photographs in black and in white, and the shape of the world is what you know until another storm ignites. Boats here will keep arriving, people gonna come and go. From my point of view, on this stool tonight, that's all you need to know. And the more that you live, and the more that you learn, that the winds here will blow, and the tide is gonna turn. But you are temporary. You are only passing through. And that the changes that come when these winds do blow, that is your maker's way to let you know that you are temporary. You are only temporary here. We are only temporary. We are only passing through. Thank you again, Helen. Thank you, Randy. Thank you guys very much. Yeah. Oh. Oh.
Yeah. Oh, that was awesome. I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell the gospel story, how it came to earth, left his home in glory, went to the cross, he washed my sins away. Hey, 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 I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell that gospel story of how he came to earth, left his home in glory, he went to the cross, wash my sins away. Hey, 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 only the name of Jesus, Jesus, the way, the truth, the life, can get me down that narrow road, keep it straight and get me right, right, right. I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell it. How it came to earth, he left his home in glory, he went to the cross, washed my sins away. Hey, 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 you know he walked on the water, ooh, changed that water into wine, so fine, made the lame to walk, made the blind to see, healed their soul. Mine, 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 I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell that gospel story of how he came to earth, left his home in glory, went to the cross, washed my sins away. Hey, hey, hey. Tell it. I'm, come on, gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell that gospel. How he came to earth, left his home in glory, went to the cross, washed my sins away. Hey, 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 listen to me. Whatever trouble that you're in, he knows what you're going through. He came, he set this old sinner free. He'll do the same for you, you, you. Oh, I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell it. God told me how it came to earth. Left his home in glory, he went to the cross, washed my sins away. Hey, hey, a cappella, I'm gonna tell it. Yeah. I'm gonna tell it. I'm gonna tell the gospel story. I came and left his home in glory, he went to the cross, washed my sins away. Hey, 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 went to the cross, washed my sins away. Went to the cross, washed my sins, went to the cross. He washed my sins away. Went to the cross. Oh, he washed my sins away. Went to the cross. Yeah, he went to the cross. You see, he went to the cross, washed my sins away. So much.
Mark Gorman. Mark Gorman. Yeah. Toronto, yeah. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Thank you all
Everybody into the hot tub. Let's go.